You saw what just happened. We played a beautiful game and we even wrote a piece of code for it. Let me now bring in a small variation to the game. And the variation is the following. I will tell you that I have a number in my mind and that number is less than 1 lakh. Come on, guess the number. How different is this game from the previous game? So, assume you keep the number 600 in your mind. I know it is less than 1 lakh, right? How on earth will I guess that it's going to be 600? I should ask you this question. Is it greater than 500? Is it greater than 10,000? Is it greater than 20,000? And so on, right? Is there a smart way of doing this? Think about it. I'm going to tell you something which looks like it's very different from the game that I've been discussing. A number between 1 to 1 lakh. Guess what the number is? A variant of what we did just now, right? I'm going to give you an example which looks very different, but these two things are the same. Example is that of, how do you search for a word in English dictionary? Let's say you want to see the word proclaim, P-R-O-C-L-A-I-M, proclaim. How will you search for this in the dictionary? You will open the dictionary in the middle. Why middle? You do not know whether proclaim is in the first half of the dictionary or the second half of the dictionary. The moment you open the dictionary in the middle, you will get words starting from N, letter N. So you know for sure that first half of the dictionary is all those words starting from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. Because you saw the word N when you opened the dictionary in the middle. So your word proclaim should be in the second half of the dictionary. So what you do is you discard the first half and only look at the second half. And again go to the center of it. Center of second half will now be, let's say, S. Words starting from S. Now what can you conclude? From A to N was first half of the dictionary which you discarded. And now when you take the midpoint of the second half, you're seeing S, which means your word proclaim should be in the first half of this little cut down dictionary. In the second half, it's in the first half, if you know what I mean, right? Think about it. Every time you open the dictionary by half, you're discarding one part of it and retaining other part of it. Correct? And so on and so forth, you finally reach the word proclaim in no time. Because your dictionary size is reducing by half. Correct? What has this to do with the problem that we were discussing? Keep a number in your mind from 1 to 1 lakh and I will guess what the number is. Can I use the way I search through a English dictionary, that same method here? Think about it. It is indeed possible. What you do is, okay, do you have a number in your mind? Is it less than 50,000 or greater than 50,000? You see what I'm doing? Like the dictionary, I'm trying to see, you see this line, is it on the left side of the, is it the first half of 1 to 1 lakh or is it in the second half? If your number is in the first half, you will say it is less than 50,000. If your number is in the second half, you will say it is greater than 50,000. And there I am, I know for sure, I can now reduce my search space by half. And now I'll ask you, is your number less than 25,000 or greater than 25,000? Do you see that this method is exactly the same as searching through an English dictionary? Let us now go ahead and try to write a piece of code for this. Whatever we did just now is popularly called the binary search. The binary search words look complicated, but there is nothing here. Binary means cut it into two pieces and search in only one piece. and continue doing it, your space where you're searching will get halved, and very, very, very quickly. Note the usage of the word very, very, very. It is indeed so quick. Very, very, very quickly, you will narrow down to your search key in no time. This is called binary search.